So long distance relationships are interesting on a psychological level. And this commitment that you're making is constantly being challenged every single day that you guys are apart. Think about it. Relationships are hard enough without throwing in a long distance component into it. Now, regular relationships require two things: intimacy and trust. You can't have true intimacy over FaceTime. That just does not work. Or even if you guys are both making the effort to see each other, let's just say every weekend, are you really having true intimacy with him when you do see him? Or is it every time that you guys get together, you feel like you're on a super condensed timeline and you have to squeeze in all those intimate moments that you would have with a normal relationship? So it ends up becoming this forced, manufactured intimacy that isn't real intimacy. Now, when it comes to trust, trust is something that naturally progresses over time in the presence of someone else. It is virtually impossible to build trust with someone who is never there physically. Like, think about it. How much better would you know this guy if he lived 5 minutes away from you versus 5 hours away from you? Now, if you're asking yourself the question, will my long-distance relationship work? There's probably a part of you that is questioning his level of commitment to seeing you, or you've just inevitably slipped into resentment mode and resenting him for the fact that he lives so far away. And I'm talking about even if this guy was boyfriend of the year and he was making all the effort to come see you every single weekend, there's still going to be a part of you that's lacking. There's going to be a part of you that is really resenting him deep down for not being closer. So now you have intimacy that's wavering at best, and you have trust that can't possibly be built. So what sort of foundation is your relationship on? Because the intimacy is good when you're with him, it's not when he's away. So it's coming and going like the tide. You will never fully be satisfied emotionally by this guy unless he moves closer to you or you move closer to him. Now, I do want to make a distinction about different types of long distance relationships. The one I'm talking about right now is, you know, you just met this guy passing through a city, and every time you go through that city, you see him, and now it's turned into a long-distance relationship. The other long-distance relationship is actually one that wasn't a long-distance relationship when it started. I'm talking about military deployments. I'm talking about you two were probably even living together, or at least living close together, and you've had that time to build that intimacy and build that trust. And now either he's going off to a deployment or she's going off to a deployment, and that partner's going to be gone for a year, and the chances of that relationship will flourish are very, very high. And you also have things with work assignments. So, you know, maybe he's got to go do a 6-month stint somewhere across the country. But again, you guys had that time to really form bonds, and it's not something where you don't really know what he's doing in that other city that he's living in. Yes, he tells you he wants to be exclusive, but you don't really know him. One of the best gifts, and I talk about this in other videos, one of the best gifts a guy can give you is giving you the gift of missing him. And just like you, you also possess that gift with him, giving the gift of missing you. The problem with long distance relationships is that you guys are constantly giving that gift to the other person. And what ends up happening is you start to idealize the relationship because you're getting this positive gift and just missing him. But you don't really know what you're missing because, again, you don't really know this guy. So you're going to be focusing on all of the positive aspects of your relationship up to this point, and you're probably going to try to really forget anything negative, or even try to forget the fact that he lives far away. And when you push that negative stuff aside, that's when resentment kicks in big time. So one of the things with this channel is I do this with clients in session, I want to give it to you straight. Okay, I don't want there to be any sort of gray area. So I really feel that long distance relationships have the best shot if you've had that period of time where you've either lived with them or you've lived close by to them for a period of months and were able to build up that intimacy and that trust, what I do not think will work, and if I'm the bearer of bad news on this one, I apologize, but I do not believe that this relationship is going to work with this guy without those two things, and you just cannot manufacture them. They have to naturally develop over time. And if you still really want to give this a shot with this guy, here is what I would do if that's your case. I would have a conversation with this guy about the future, and I would bring up marriage, and I would bring up children, because honestly, not everyone wants those things, but if this thing has a chance to grow into the future, those are questions that are going to come up. So you don't want to put yourself in a situation where you really have no future with this guy. There's no way this can move forward because you want kids and now you've learned he does not. How does that work? That's not going to work. So I would have that future conversation with him. I would also find out what are the chances that you guys could either move in together or move closer together to really be able to build up those two things we were talking about. So that's my two cents on long distance relationships. Just remember intimacy and trust. Constantly be evaluating those two things and just let them naturally grow over time. Trust me, a big part of him will really appreciate and respect the fact that you're sitting down and having this adult conversation, because he's probably going through similar feelings. He's wondering if this is worth it. And if you can just have a frank discussion with him, I think you guys will be able to figure out pretty quickly if your status is going to change and this will no longer be labeled a long distance relationship because one of you or both of you are willing to seriously do something about that.